Tell you what, the gentleman sitting next to me, one of my favorite people to have on the Expresso couch, Mr. Deon Lotz, a man who's been making waves in the film industry, not just locally, but internationally as well, winning the 2011 Zurich Film Festival Award for Skoornate, and also having played alongside great actors in Long Walk to Freedom, and most recently, Kite, his project that he's going to be bringing to us right now, talking to us, and very, very exciting stuff. Good to have you, first of all.
Thank you very much.
Do you feel like part of the furniture?
I am. I change like the furniture. I think this is my 10th time here, but thanks for having me again.
Yes, but let's talk about Kite, a very exciting project that you worked on involving Samuel L. Jackson.
That's
playing
right.
A detective Prinsloo.
Prinsloo.
And we were talking just now, just quickly, about the first time that you met him. You met him for the first time in the makeup room.
Yeah. We were in the trailer being made up, and he was sitting there being all, you know, dollied up.
Yeah.
With his, there we go.
There we go.
At least the hairstyles are the same, so we need a lot of powder, both of us. But it was great. And at the end, he did commend me and say thank you. It was nice working with me. So it's great.
And the extreme differences that you were pointing out between the two of you. You had just quickly, like, he had a trailer.
No, he's got the big trailer. I'm in a banger where there's three, you know, units. I mean, he arrives with an entourage of two people. I come with my briefcase. You know, so there's a difference. I think his paycheck is different as well. So I know his paycheck is different. But hey, it's an honor, and it's nice working with him. And it was great. He's very suave on set.
Yeah.
You know, and
Sam.
He's Sam.
Yeah. What was it like working alongside this A-list actor? The chemistry, because you guys actually play opposite each other.
We do.
A bit of the story as well.
That was great because I mean, the story itself, obviously, it's an anime movie, and very popular anime and. Yeah, as I say, that suaveness coming in with the keys and everything, you know, they bring his jacket, he's there. And it was great because you kind of have there is an energy. I mean, he certainly has a presence on set.
Yes.
And I believe that, you know, one must have that. So for me, it was great to work opposite him.
I can't wait to see it. It looks really, really good, especially that it's made in South Africa. I really love that. And also another project that you've been working on that's also made in South Africa. You were telling me you're going to be on the set just now after this interview.
I'm on my way to that.
Is Wallander, right? Mm-hmm. And you're playing alongside Kenneth Branagh. That's amazing.
Yeah, no, Sir Ken, I mean... I arrived on set and I said, Sir Kenneth, he said, no, just call me Ken.
But what a
gentleman. He's a great guy.
Yeah.
We sit down and talk about theatre and all kinds of things. But yeah, I mean, this is the series Wallander. It's a BBC series. And it's a very popular series. And it's great to be on set with him. And it's a wonderful honour.
Wow. So why do you think is it that all these international series and films keep coming back? Because it's not like it's happened 10 times now. It's happened multiple times. Why do they keep coming back?
Great locations. Yeah. Fantastic crews, wonderful production companies like out of Africa.
Yeah.
Talent, yeah, I think we've got the talent as well. Obviously, South Africa is a cheap destination. But, I mean, besides that, we have the scenic beauty.
Yeah.
I mean, it's got all the variety that a film company would require,
yeah.
Whether it's down in Cape Town or wherever in the country.
Yeah. And, I mean, isn't it about time that we as a South African public started supporting our own local production?
Oh, we must.
Skoornate did so well.
Oh, absolutely. Internationally.
Yeah.
But locally not. I mean, that's still, you know, one of my greatest achievements, I think. Skoornate, yeah. It's really fantastic. But people need to understand locally, South African market must go and support South African films. I still challenge Ster-Kinekor and New Metro, and I say, have a screen just dedicated for South African films and repeat the movies.
Oh, right, okay.
Show so that South Africans, because they always come and say, oh, we wanted to come and see your movie. And by that time, it's all finished.
Yeah.
So keep the movie rolling, keep it on for a month or two, change them. Every hour can be a different movie, but let people go and experience South African films and support South African movies. It's important.
I love that. And I also love doing in Sleepers Wake as well.
Thank you.
Do you have a favorite role among, would you say Skoornate is the one or,
well,
I don't know.
Skoornate certainly did internationally well for me.
I mean,
you know, it certainly placed me on the map. I arrived in Toronto and a guy came up with a picture of me saying, please could you sign that? I mean, that was 2 years after when we were doing Long Walk to Freedom. So yeah, certainly people have taken note. But I don't have a favorite role. I love being a different character in every role and looking different and things.
And just finally, very quickly, to young and aspiring actors out there who want to make it like you have, what's the key?
Keep at it. It's hard work. Nothing comes easy. But if you're dedicated, if you're motivated, driven, you can make it.
Fantastic. Well, listen, it's always great to have you here.
Thanks for having me
back.
Great
to hear about your success. Can't wait to see Kite.
Go and
check it out. Oh, my goodness. Well, stay tuned to your Feel Good Breakfast show. We'll be back with more after this short break.